Yeah, please come on.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon. Sit down. Please sit down.
Thank you, sir.
Is your father also a doctor?
Yes, sir. He's a veterinary doctor.
Okay. And you have done your MBBS?
Yes, sir.
Now, after, are you practicing as a doctor?
Sir, I'm working with PGI Chandigarh and Philips CSR. And I have an organization named Nivedita with them. So we are working in the Tri-City towards specifically breast carcinoma awareness and screening.
Ms. Darpan.
Yes, sir.
NRC is in the news.
Yes, sir.
NRC in the context of Assam.
Yes.
How did it come about? What is the historical background to the NRC in Assam?
Yes. So the historical background dates back to decades ago, when the issue of Bangladesh, erstwhile East Pakistan, was there, and the persecution by West Pakistan, thereby leading to the refugee influx in Northeast, leading to the subsequent demographic change. Thereafter, there were many protests by the locals and the tribals, and then...
Who led the movement?
So it was by the National Democratic Front of Bodoland, including, and then there was the All Assam Students Union, ASTU. Yes.
NDFP's demand was totally different.
Yes, sir.
Which has been sorted out.
Yes, sir.
ASTU was the one which spearheaded the movement,
yes,
against the Bangladeshi. So
yes,
what happened?
So post that, the Assam Accord of 1985 was signed.
Right.
And then...
What did the accord say?
So the accord had many provisions.
Just in the context of NRC.
Yes, sir. So that an NRC specifically for Assam would be created, with the cutoff date being 25th of December 1900.
March.
Sorry,
March.
Sir.
71.
March.
Right. Okay.
1970.
So that is the Assam Accord 85. Then what happened?
So then this issue of the NRC, it was postponed for some time. Then the Supreme Court gave the...
So before that you had a tripartite agreement of 2005.
Yes, sir.
Right? In which they said that we will implement the Assam Accord.
Yes.
Then nothing all happened. So the Supreme Court. So what happened? Supreme Court?
Gave the directions.
Correct.
Yes.
So now the NRC process has been completed.
Yes.
And how many people are still left out of the NRC?
So there are around 40 lakh or so.
19 lakhs now.
Yes, sorry.
Now
after
19,
phase 2.
After phase 2, it
yes,
is 19 lakhs.
Yes, sir.
So what is the procedure prescribed now for these 19 lakhs?
Yes.
Is there an appeal somewhere?
Yes, sir. So there is an appeal at the district level. There are multiple layers of appeal, starting from the district level, and then subsequently the judiciary, it can be approached,
yeah,
the High
Court. The initial stage, there will be the appellate tribunals, foreigners appellate tribunals,
yes,
which,
sir,
have been set up there. So this is the NRC. Now, what is the reason why the Citizenship Amendment Act of 2019, why is it being opposed in Assam and some of the other northeastern states?
So at the outset, firstly, there was a lot of misinformation rather than information about the Citizenship Amendment Act.
Just come to this, just one point.
Yes,
what is,
sir,
the one single point? Why are they protesting against this? There's no misinformation.
So
what is the reason?
So if it is, if it comes into being and the Northeast, it is not excluded out of it, then they have fears that the influx of more number of the non-locals will lead
You're
to more...
You're still not coming to the point. The only difference is, what was the cutoff date for the NRC?
Yes, sir. So there's a difference. That is 1971.
That is all. That's the only reason. 1971, cutoff for CA?
2014.
That is the context. They are only saying that you can't change the goalposts.
Yes.
We have agreed on this. Now you are going to allow all these people. All that issue of religion and all that, that is not relevant for the Northeast. That is being, it's a different issue, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, you know these Khelo India games, which were started by the government. Last year they had the Khelo India school games. Now this year they are planning Khelo India youth games. Where are they being planned? Any idea?
Sir, I'm sorry,
And in the budget, is there been any allocation for these Khelo India youth games?
So I'm sure they must have been.
There is an increment of about 300 crores in that. Okay.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir.
That one?
Yes.
Recently, Government of India has taken a very significant decision in the domain of women's reproductive health rights.
Yes, sir.
Can you enlighten us about that?
Yes, sir. So, there have been many decisions taken, but I think the two most important ones have been the surrogacy bill, which is in the pipeline, and also the recent amendment to the MTP Act of 1971.
Yeah.
Coming to the MTP amendment,
yeah.
It is postulated that it is proposed that the abortion gestational cutoff age will be increased from 20 to 24 weeks. In addition to that, if there is pregnancy due to contraceptive failure, and it has been extended to the unmarried women as well.
Okay, thank you, very good. With regard to Ayushman Bharat,
yes, sir.
Has the current budget proposed any enhanced allocation or is it stagnant?
So there has been the enhancement of allocation from the total around 68,000 crore to the health sector, about 8,000 crore or so.
Overall health sector. But
yes, sir.
I'm asking you a specific question.
Yes, sir.
On Ayushman Bharat, has there been any increase?
Yes, sir. I believe there has been the increase to 8,000 crore. Before that, at the very beginning, only 2,000 crore were allocated when it came into being in September of 2019.
Okay, and is it also now encouraging participation of the private sector?
Yes, sir. So more than 20,000 hospitals have already been empaneled under it. And in addition to that, to give impetus to it, via the PPP route and viability gap funding, new
right.
hospitals will be made.
Right, excellent. Can you tell us something about the direct tax reforms carried out or proposed in the budget?
So, with respect to the direct tax reform, an amnesty scheme similar for the indirect taxpayers has been proposed, and in which the one-time declaration and the payment of the penalty and interest payments will be there. In addition to that, the number of the slabs have also been increased, and there is and many exemptions and deductions. If they are not undertaken, then for certain categories, there will be the decrease in the income tax as well.
There is a tax chapter also which has been
yes.
proposed to be introduced. What is that?
So
what does it entail? Tax chapter. Yeah.
So I'm not too sure of the exact what the charter entails, but I believe that it was a suggestion of the direct tax code reform panel which was set up last year.
Charter means charter of rights.
Yes,
what
sir.
The taxpayer, what kind of rights the taxpayer enjoys.
Yes.
And India would be the fourth country in the world to have introduced this.
You
have been a champion sprinter, I can see from your sheet.
Yes,
now, who has been the greatest female sprinter in India?
So, the greatest female sprinter, there have been many, but if I talk about the past, who brought it to the foreground,
yeah.
it was P.T. Usha.
Okay.
And
and there is a new kid on the block.
Yes, sir.
What's her name?
So there is Miss Duti Chand as well as Miss Hima Das.
Okay.
Yes,
Hima Das, which are her events?
So Hima Das is
how did she come into the limelight?
Yes, sir.
She did something extraordinary in an international athletic meet. Which one was that?
So coming to the first part, Hima Das generally participates in the 400 meter sprint.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
The World Junior Athletics Championships, she
yes.
won the gold medal.
Yes,
and what about Duti Chand?
Sir, Duti Chand is a 100 meter sprinter.
Yes, she also won an international honors
yes, sir.
Last year.
Okay. And sir, I'm not aware of the game, but I think...
World University Champion in the 100 meters.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
You've conducted organ donation drives.
Yes,
why do we find that organ donation is at such a dismal level in our country? People are not willing to donate organs.
Yes, ma'am. The reasons are multifold. They are from the societal level as well as from the health administration point of view. Coming to the societal level, there are many misconceptions amongst the people. Mm-hmm. For example, some believe that they will not go for the next, or the rebirth will not be there, or their loved one's body will be mutilated. So that is there. At the health administration, or from the health personal point of view, the private hospitals who want to mint money, they seldom refrain from giving the birth a brain dead certificate quickly. And then broadly, the other ones include that there is a widening trust deficit with respect to the healthcare sector and the people.
So do we have any rules governing organ donation in our country?
Yes, ma'am.
What are these?
Ma'am, they are governed under the Transplantation of the Human Organ Act.
Mm-hmm.
And if someone wants to donate the whole body, then it is under the Anatomy Act of 1994.
So when someone wants to donate an organ, can you donate to a person who is not a blood relative?
Yes, ma'am. And moreover, this donor's information, it is also kept anonymous. So it can be both blood as well as non-blood.
Okay. Now, one hears very often of this term antimicrobial resistance. What is this and why is it becoming so significantly important?
Ma'am, antimicrobial resistance, as the name indicates, it is the resistance or the inability to kill the microbes, be it bacteria or the viruses.
Why is that so?
Ma'am, there are two causes. These are natural and acquired.
Mm-hmm.
But it has been in news currently, more so because of the acquired causes.
So what is the government doing to look at this particular problem, AMR?
Ma'am, the government is working at both the international as well as at the domestic level. At the international level, it is a part and a signatory of the WHO action plan on the antimicrobial resistance. And at the domestic level, we have a red line campaign in which both the chemists as well as the people are being taught which medicines are to be taken on prescription and which are not. They have a red line. And then we...
Not only taking on prescription, they must complete the entire period of taking all these antibiotics.
Yes.
That's one of the reasons why we are developing this problem.
Yes.
Okay. Now, you are a doctor.
Yes,
what are the problems which doctors face while they are working in hospitals? Are you aware?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, let's hear.
Ma'am, there are multiple problems.
Mm-hmm.
First of all, their workload is quite high. Ideally, one doctor should see, by the international standards, not more than 15 to 20 patients in an hour. That is the maximum limit.
Okay.
But in India, the patients are so, there is such a lot of burden that about even 100 patients are checked in 1 hour in the OPDs of the government hospitals. So this is one point.
So one is workload.
Yes,
anything
ma'am.
Anything
else? Ma'am, second is with respect to especially the recent incidents, the trust deficit which has been created between the two parties, the doctors and the patients,
okay.
and the lack of the counselors, especially in the trauma centers, which leads to violence against the doctors as well.
So you say security of doctors? That's
yes,
the major issue?
Security and lack of counselors.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
That one, you are from Punjab.
Yes, sir.
We hear about this drug problem in Punjab. Tell
yes,
me something about what were the causes and what has the government done to address this issue?
Sir, Punjab's history, geography and the contemporary issues have all led to the drug problem in Punjab. First of all, coming to the geography, Punjab is at the crossroads of the Indo-Pakistan border. So there is the golden crescent of the drug cultivation in Iran, Afghanistan and Pakistan. Secondly, coming to the historical reasons, Punjab is an agrarian state. So in order to do the work, they required small doses of drugs, which has compounded into the problem that it is today. The other reasons, contemporary ones especially, these include that there is a gap between the drug de-addiction and the rehabilitation. Secondly, we have the paucity of the enough counseling for the women especially, because the load of the women drug addicts in Punjab, it is greater than the national average.
What is the government doing?
Sir, at the domestic level of Punjab, there are various campaigns. For example, there is the Ubharta Bathinda campaign, which is by the SSP of Bathinda, which is essentially a community police initiative in which they identify the chronic drug users and the law enforcement gaps, they are plugged. In addition to that, the funding for the drug de-addiction centers has also been increased. Also, a special task force has been created by the Punjab police. And some very novel measures the dediction centers exclusively for females are also in the pipeline.
Now, with some confirmed cases and some suspicions,
yes,
about the coronavirus cases in India,
yes,
what are the preventive and management measures? Some of them have been announced by the government recently.
Yes, sir. So first of all, the preventive measures, they have been since the epicenter is in Wuhan. So we are doing the thermal screening at the airports and the quarantining and isolation if required. Secondly, we are spreading respiratory etiquette awareness amongst the population. And amongst the management measures that the government is taking, we have created special isolation wards. And also at the level of the CEPI, that is the Coalition for the Epidemic Preparedness Innovation, India is a very big forerunner in that. So we are also preparing a drug and a vaccine at the global level.
What are some major public health issues,
yes, sir,
in India?
So amongst the major public health issues, I'd like to divide it into health and its determinants, which are more important. So with respect to health, first of all, the infrastructure and the funding, which has not reached the ideal level of 2.5% of the GDP till now. Then we have a severe paucity at the grassroots level of the low level or the mid-level healthcare cadre. It is still not being strengthened with respect to be it salary, training or even motivation. For example, Anganwadi workers and the A&M workers, etc. Then when we come to the determinants of health, then the obvious determinants include sanitation and the water connection. They also need to be looked upon.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
What is the size of our budget which has just been introduced?
Yes.
How much expenditure is it is planned to spend?
So it the revenue expenditure, I think in total it is around 25 lakh crore. So the revenue is 24 lakh crore, I'm aware of only that.
No, revenue is,
yes,
there. I'm talking of the size of the budget, which means,
yes,
they intend to spend so much.
Yes, sir.
Then I'll ask you a question from where the revenue will come.
Sir, I'll check upon that. Yes, sir.
30 lakh crores.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
It was about 27 last year.
Yes, sir.
26.9, that's 30 lakh.
Yes, sir.
Now the question, next question is, what are the sources of revenue now,
mm-hmm,
which government has highlighted,
yes,
for this budget?
So the sources of the revenue in the descending order, these include first is the borrowing and the other liabilities.
The first, the most important.
So it is both GST as well as the corporation tax.
Tax is the,
yes,
first, yes.
So then after this comes the income tax and...
No, income tax, direct and indirect, both taxes, that is, they are the biggest component.
Yes,
next.
So after the income tax, these include, sir, I'll take a
break. Yeah, take your time,
yes,
and tell me.
GST, corporation tax, followed by the income tax, then we have the
all taxation
payments.
Is,
yes,
the largest component.
Yes, sir.
But that there would be a shortfall,
yes,
if there were no other avenues,
yes, sir,
for of income. What are those which government is looking at?
Sir, we are referring to the non-tax revenue. In particular, the disinvestment proceeds.
Very good. How much?
So
the
target? So it is rupees 2.1 lakh crore.
Excellent. Very good. What else?
So then we also have the non-debt capital receipts as well. Yes.
That is all?
So we have the other borrowings also from, and the funding by the sovereign wealth funds and the foreign governments and foreign investors as well.
Okay. Right. You should check up on this.
Yes, sir.
There are several,
I will,
sources.
Yes, sir.
Now, you were asked a question about Punjab drug problem.
Yes, sir.
Is it true that 89% of the drug addicts are literate and educated?
Sir, I would not be able to comment on the veracity of this figure, 89%. But yes, many drug addicts are literate in Punjab.
And 83% of them have jobs. This is a central government in, report.
Yes, sir.
Central government of India.
Yes, sir.
In 2015, commissioned a report. It gives these figures. So it is. It may not be very correct to say that it is illiterate labor and all only,
yes,
who are there.
Yes, sir.
Some problem is something deeper.
Yes, sir.
Now, When Mr. Amarinder Singh, your present Chief Minister,
yes.
was in opposition, he went after the Adali family, you know, that they are the people who are the linchpin of drug mafia. Who was the man they named?
So I believe it was the
Majithia,
related,
right?
Yes, sir.
Son-in-law of, what has happened to that? Have the cases been registered? Now I don't find Mr. Amarinder Singh making any statements. What
yes.
happened to that?
So it is still in limbo.
Limbo?
Yes, sir.
Why?
So there are many issues and
political?
The litigation is going
political?
On.
Political?
So I would not
okay.
be able to comment on the political aspect.
What is Punjab's GDP? Size of GDP?
So it is around 15 lakh crore
no,
something.
No, it's very low.
2.76 lakh crore and it is 14th with respect to GDP.
It's a little more than 5 lakh crore.
Okay.
Which is
yes.
the highest in India? Which state?
So I think it should be one of either Maharashtra or Gujarat. But from one from the southern states. Yes, sir.
Number two, number three?
So number two would be again Karnataka or
Tamil
Nadu. Tamil Nadu.
Have you read something? Are you looking at newspapers carefully?
Yes, sir. I try to.
The situation, the picture of the economy front looks very dismal. Right?
Yes.
4.5%. Last 5 quarters, it has registered a decline in GDP growth.
Yes.
Consumption is low. Capacity in industry is lying idle. However, I've been reading for the last 7-8 days, there have been some green shoots, as they call it, green shoots. Some indications that some of this activity is picking up.
Yes, sir.
Have you been able to, would you be able to make any comment on this, whether green shoots are appearing, and if so,
yes, sir.
Where, in which sector?
Sir, I'll try. So the indicators which have been cited, which are the green shoots of the economy, have been the positive growth of the Purchasing Managers Index, PMI, the index of the industrial production.
Yes, PMI in what? Industrial?
Yes, sir.
Yes, very good.
So, and the...
How much it has registered in January?
So it has become positive. That is...
No, positive it was
yes,
for last 2
yes,
months.
Sir. Yes, sir.
November, it is from November, there is an uptick. Up to
yes.
November, there was a decline.
Yes, sir.
November, December, but January it has registered a huge jump.
Okay, sir.
You didn't read today's figure?
Sir, I do not know the exact figure.
55,
but
55.
Okay, sir.
Anything
you.
Above 50
mm-hmm.
means
expansion.
That they are ordering more and more, you know, raw material,
yes,
etc.
Yes, sir.
All right. So that is
what?
Industrial.
Yes,
what
sir.
Else?
Sir, then the power output, it is also increasing.
No,
it was also.
No, don't say that. Our output is low. What else?
So the...
There are three sectors you talk, focus on.
So,
those three.
Yes, sir. So in agricultural exports...
Check up on this.
Yes, sir.
All right. How much we spend in the percentage of GDP on health?
So currently it is around 1.14%.
1.14.
Yes, sir.
How much does Bangladesh spend?
So it is around 5 to 8%. I do not know the exact figure, but within this range.
You are very low, huh?
Yes, sir.
And as compared in the BRICS, where how much we has, how do we compare with others?
So in BRICS, Brazil is investing more than 5% of the GDP. Then China.
What is the desirable percentage we should be spending in order to improve our healthcare?
So ideally it should be around 4 to 5% of GDP.
Good. Right, we close the interview here.
Thank
I give
you,
you feedback.
Yes, sir.
I think I'm echoing the opinion of everyone here when I say you perform very well.
Okay.
You have a very rational approach to things. You are able to express yourself very nicely. So that is a plus point for you. Now, we have tried to base our questions on your depth,
yes,
starting with Punjab and
then your medical, your other important strong points, and then on major current issues like economy, coronavirus, etc. We feel these are the areas on which your questioning would be based.
Yes.
So my suggestion to you would be that you do two things now. One is that you take the video from here, take a look at your performance, find an answer to these 20 questions we have asked you. They are all very relevant questions.
Yes.
And find good answers. You, like Punjab drug was a very important thing which you were asked. And then start reading newspapers very carefully.
Yes.
And whatever important item is there, like I told you about this green shoot, today it has appeared. There's a very nice chart in Financial Express.
Yes.
Pick up that, take it out, you know, keep those cuttings, read them again and again.
Yes.
That will build up your, what you call, knowledge bank.
Yes.
So, that is all we like to say.
Thank you, sir. Another question, if I may ask, from ma'am. Ma'am, is my attire appropriate
for
it?
Perfect. Very good.
Okay. All right. Thank you.
Good luck. You're building up your knowledge. Yeah?
Yes.
Otherwise, you're doing very well.
Thank you, sir.
Good.
Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss an update.